Regal Cinemas suspending operations in its more than 500 U.S. locations. This is blockbuster films such as the new James Bond movie continue to be delayed in the wake of the pandemic. Regal's parent Cineworld also temporarily closing its theaters in the U.K. The company shares, as you might imagine, along with AMC, Cinemark, they're all going to be down. At least it looks like they will. The CEO of Cineworld, by the way, will be joining us later this morning. No surprise, guys, Jim. I mean, given how few people were showing up and the fact that there's not much to show them to begin with.
But how about what Adam Aron's going to do? I mean, I find that this is something...
Adam Aron, of course, CEO of AMC.
Yes. I mean, look, when you don't have... I mean, if you're watching Netflix, for instance, there's not... You know that there's going to be an end to the new stuff for the most part, unless they all find a bubble to be able to do movies. So you've got this 1-2 punch of them delaying movies. And then where's the new content coming from, David? I don't know where it's going to come from.
I think there's limited production going on now, Jim. But you're right. There was an interregnum that went as long as, 5-6 months, probably.
Right.
And then the question is, what are you going to do? Not just if you're an exhibitor like this, but to your point, to the many streaming services that we all rely on for our reliable entertainment, there will be perhaps a need to go deeper and deeper into the catalog.
Yeah, I mean, Carl, I think one of the things that's amazing about this is you're starting to realize that, frankly, we're back to just video games and NFL once the NBA's done. But the NFL, I bet you, we need to see those numbers, particularly for a game that was last night that was one of the most exciting games that we've seen this year, Carl.
Well, your Eagles are now head of the NFC East, Jim. Congratulations.
Yeah, you know what shows you dominance? I think we're dominant in the NFC East.
Dominant.
Dominant.
No more banged up birds.
No.
I see Schefter says this morning the Titans have had no new positives for the first time in 7 days.
I think that that is so important because remember where we are. Day eight is the, you know, a lot of people think like the CEO of BioReference Labs has often talked about day eight as being the cutoff. So let's analogize that to what's happening with the president. And you do get a kind of a better handle than just the usual 14-day thing. Because, again, the Titans are being tested by this PCR method, which is the method that is closest to 100%.
Yeah.
So you got a pretty good timeline.
Oof. And we can see there the performance of
David,
Cineworld.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Carl.
And I was going to say, David, also reminds me of the downgrade today of AT&T over at Key. They go to underweight, 25 target, not so much on theatrical pipeline, but more August deceleration in ARPU and DirecTV.
Yeah, I mean, listen, Direct is, there's a process going on there for potential sale of that asset, private equity, the most likely buyer. At some point, I hope to update people on that because I've heard there certainly was a hope to try and get something announced before the end of the year. So we're only a couple of months away. 2 or 3 months from potentially at least what they wanted to do there. HBO Max, you know, I mean, they did an interview. The Wall Street Journal had an interview over the weekend that they shared with John Stankey, the CEO. He's still hopeful for success of HBO Max, as seems to indicate it's still key to the company's future in many ways. It hasn't gotten off to a great start, to your point. Backing up for a minute, just back to sort of the overall conversation about COVID. Jim, we're still hovering above 40,000 new cases a day in the United States. And I think that's worth mentioning. Thankfully, the rate of serious complications and death has come down as, look what's happening with the president, as we found different ways to treat the disease, as we were much more well-informed, and also, frankly, as the population of those getting it seems to be younger, given college campuses and the like. But 40,000-plus new cases a day is not good.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.